वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लोन ट्रैवलर रिटन बाय मंज सक्सेना। आई कुड सेंस इट, सेड आराधना टू हर रूममेट। इट वाज नॉट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट आराधना हैड कम बैक ऑल अलोन फ्रॉम हर हाउस आफ्टर लॉन्ग वेकेशंस। शी वाज ऑलवेज इन टाइम बट टुडे शी वाज 4 hours लेट, व्हिच हैड लेफ्ट ऑल द पीपल इन द होस्टल वरीड। She had boarded the train on time but not reached by that train. In fact, she had reached by some other train and that too 4 hours late. She didn't discuss much with the hostel authorities. She simply said that she had missed the train while she got down to fill her water bottle. However, it sounded weird. Why would anyone get down with bags to fill water bottle? An unasked question remained on everyone's lips. Later at night, when Aradhana and her roommate were alone in the room, she held her hand and said, "Please, don't share it with anyone, but today I could have been abducted from the previous train I was in. I am really scared." Her grip tightened on her friend's hand as she continued, "Today morning, when I boarded the train, it was occupied with a group of very smart-looking girls who were traveling with their aunt and a cousin. The first sight of them gave my mother a sense of relief, and very happily she shared her concern about me traveling alone and also told them to take care of me if I required. I had the upper berth, and as usual, I went up to sleep before dozing off. I saw another girl entering. She was also traveling alone. She sat there reading a book. We exchanged formal smiles and focused on our own task. When I got up after an hour, I observed that one of the girls and her cousin were not there. After a long time, when they returned, I could observe something fishy in their eyes. One of the sisters then asked for the other solo traveler for her water bottle. And as she was drinking water, I think I saw a strange movement in her hand, as if she was dropping something into it. The other girls also took a sip or two and sat down looking outside her window. After some time, she started feeling nauseous. The boy immediately got up and took her to the washroom. This was around 4 stations before ours. The stations passed one by one. On the second station after that, one of the girls asked me for my water bottle. I gave it. Again, while drinking water, I saw the same movement. By this time, I was already alert, as none of the passengers except me had shown interest in knowing the whereabouts of the missing girl. So, before the last station before mine, I opened my bottle to drink water. But as I could observe, there were some keen eyes following my action, and something made turn the water bottle upside down, letting each drop fall. And before anyone could understand, I got down, picked my bag and bottle and left them by saying, "I will get it filled." Without waiting for their response, I got down on that station and moved towards the control room. Luckily, the station superintendent was also there. I told him of my observation and that I need to board the next train. There were 2 lady police officers dressed in civilian dress who immediately got up and got on the train. The proceeding continued at their level, and before getting on to the next train all I was informed was that the other girl had been forced to get down on the previous station, and I was actually a gang working under the cover of an event management company. If my intuition had not warned me, I would have been so. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe my channel.